track temperature's decreasing. It's now 45 Celsius. It looks clear. Sector 1 is 0.5 off the pace. The guy in front has just done a 128.5.
deep in the field here.
Track temperature is increasing. It's now 50 Celsius.
Should be fun. Too afraid to the race. Baby camera over so I could see it at least. Driving. Okay.
Pit exit's clear. Two laps to set a decent time. We'll be right back. P8.
Bad.
Did Patrick have incident on his lap? Yeah. Okay, that makes sense why he didn't knock me down. Should be a tough race. Top 11 within a second of qualifying. And my Red Bull. And how hot is the track? 51, you son of a bitch. Literally molten lava for a track surface.
That's the end of the session, P11.
Bets opened. Use BetWin100 to make a bet. Number 19 Dustin Dawes starts 11th.
Guys, we've had a great weekend so far. It's a beautiful day for a race. So remember, just like we spoke about, it's all about the details, making things a non-issue today. Nice and smooth on the fuel, nice and smooth on the lug nuts, nice and smooth on the racetrack and the pit calls. Earl, you do a good job up there, and I think we're all in store for a fantastic day. Right side on the restart.
Remember, guys, it's a single-class event. Any GT2s overtaking GT1s will score 50% more points.
Why you gotta do that to us?
Because he's the pace car.
Not today. I'm in anime weeb trash here today.
Oh, really? Bring out the otaku's at Okayama spirit, huh?
I am safety car in Ford and otaku in Aston. It's the only way to be. We got Javier here, too. We got communism represented in multiple forms. Really shaping up to be a great motor racing event.
C8.
30. Minutes, B11. The track temp is 51 Celsius. The air temp is 28 Celsius. Follow car number 17 in the left column. Get ready, mate, it's hammer time.
Put my back in that seat real quick, give yourself a real quick tug. Double check your steering wheel. Get ready to roll here. Pace car's off, be ready.
Oh, that's a tiny gap.
Yeah, we got bunched up really badly.
Death turn one.
Driver off straight, looking good.
Well, that's it for me.
need to find a way to get around this guy. Not that I think I'm that much faster than him. That's really bad.
Alright, Dustin, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake.
Five. He came in most carefully. What are you doing? What are you doing? I guess this is what happens when asking drivers don't get seconds that are available for free on those forms.
Clear.
Sorry, Luke, I didn't mean to dive bomb you there. You slid more than I thought.
left turn 2, left turn 2, left turn 2. All Austin drivers under 1,000 km. Freeze at the bottom of the floor. Go get it. Stop causing wrecks. Guys, our Gladys is being broadcast to somebody on TV today.
Oh, are we on the YouTube today?
Say that again, Thomas.
No, Thomas, I don't think we're being broadcast today.
No, the boys on the two races.
Looks
so much
like Seth got murdered again.
Stuff, so they're probably...
Sorry, can you repeat?
Well, I guess they can't make fun of us then.
Yeah, they gotta make fun of these useless assholes.
Oh yeah, Seth got murdered.
Seth got murdered.
Yeah, Robert got murdered. And I'm getting chased by Patrick. Audrius got murdered. This has been a race.
Faster than Patrick. Don't worry about him.
Okay. Disable user leave quit messaging.
right. You're clear.
That was scary.
Justin, stay close. Wait for him to make a mistake. Lower class car ahead. On your right.
It's frustrating.
The Yatsu Marino ahead is increasing. It's now 1.3 seconds.
On your left. You're clear him.
Come on, Dario, don't do that.
It's too kind to creep in me. You have broken my race.
Come on, man. Fabian, look at the replay and it was only a miscall.
I hope he's a Netla.
Pick me up for the race.
Oh, mate, you don't have a black flag for that.
Oh, how I wish you could give me the black flag for it.
I just drove by a sick, depth wrecked bucket of fuck. And he's still gonna beat me with it because I had to pit for mine.
Come on, fellas.
It's getting spicy, LUL.
Yeah, hey, people are... tempers are flaring.
Come on, I'm waiting for you. I'm gonna break early.
Thank you.
But I just... Lucas is like doing basically the same time as me.
Yellow flag, caution.
Came out here.
From what I've seen, you've been doing similar times all race long.
Yeah, this means like I can't really pass him. Best I can do is hold formation. The one chance I did have to pass him, I let him keep the position because it was a shitty dive bomb. Oops.
Sadly, that's the only way to pass around here.
Yeah, but that it was too shitty with dive bomb. What are people doing? Taylor, that was very unsafe. Worst part is, for some of their safe I ratings, that dude will probably gain I rating out of this race, despite driving like a missile.
That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
2 minutes, so I kind of have like one lap if I'm gonna make this happen. Ah, just a bit too tight. Come on, Thomas. Set the pick.
You're coming up on a slower car. One more to go.
You do realize this is the equivalent of a go-kart track. It's quite hard to rotate. Don't die, bomb people.
Scare him a bit there.
Yeah, you should have committed to the outside.
Yeah, I thought I might have been able to cross him back over, but nope.
Please, park on the track. You
just
have to go get people for it.
Good race, Lucas. Great defense, but on that last lap there, that was cool.
P9. That's the end of the race. We'll get him next time.
Please, just a PSA, don't park in turn one. You're going to have people hit you because you do it unexpectedly. Go around the track.
Good race, Stefan. Good race. Very good race.
Javier. Oh, Javier.
Happy I didn't crash.
Ma veramente stupido sei.
Well, that was, of course, a pretty big disappointment. RIP.
I love the pit entrance chime on this track.
Pit lane speed limit is 60 kilometers per hour. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
I don't know what the SLF of this race was, but
go.
I'm still fairly happy with that.
Really enjoy the Aston. They've always been driving the Aston, even when the Aston was bad.
Be ready for a funny. Ethan, look at my lap one.
It says 2.3k.
It'll be odd.
That's probably for all cars.
Yeah, I was behind you when that happened. I'm like, that was unfortunate.
Also, why did my Netflix start? That's weird.
9 minutes of repairs.
Really? Oh, damn. That's yay, new damage bundle.
I totally had him and looked up there.
You've even throw the car into the air. Like, that should be a tiny rub, but nothing should actually really happen there.
Oh yeah, I should have just drove it around. Well, I think I would have lost
my
time.
Yeah, you don't even touch. Like, wow, Mike's not good.
Also, watch Thomas's last lap. What a wrecked bucket of fuck.
How on earth is that 9 minutes of repair? You don't even touch a barrier. What on earth? What, did you just have broken steering?
I have no clue.
Mm.
Should happen. It's racing.
What happened?
Wow, that's just insane. That makes absolutely no sense. That has to be a bug.
I know, Patrick's just slower.
Oh, well.
Mike, did you get a meatball?
It's hilarious. What happened in turn one?
Oh, yeah.
Wow, okay. No, that's a bug. I'm going to clip the replay and then send it in and ask them, what the fuck? How was it a meatball?
Well, look at the race that I did yesterday. The guy spun into me.
The strikes, but apparently not.
The race yesterday, the guy that hit me, he got meatballed. I was perfectly fine, and it didn't look like he had any damage, but he was definitely off pace.
I'm just going to say that Reed rolled a good hit.
I've been seeing a lot of meatballs getting called on cars on, like, the Twitch shows on YouTube.
Oof. I feel bad for laughing, but this is like teammates taking each other out. Shades of Ferrari there.
If you want to watch Thomas Ferrier's last lap, it's hilarious.
Maybe this will be another race where he'll actually finally admit that, yes, he's a cat.
Yeah, what's with the no gap?
Lap 2.
The GT1 slowed up really badly for the start. Like, we were almost stopped before the last corner.
We still didn't leave much of a gap, though.
And it took out, like, the top 8 GTs. 2s.
Oh, yeah, like...
If you lap 1 where all the GT2s died, it was actually lap 2, because we came across a spun car at the big hairpin after the back straight. It was just crazy. And then later in the race, a couple more cars died, and I just get pushed first. Okay, this is the luckiest podium ever. Pain. Honestly, I know it's a bad thing to say, but I think if you're under 1,000 hour rating, it probably means you don't practice enough.
I mean, depends. Like, yesterday, the GT2s I did, qualifying is my practice, and I was fine, but I guess it's more experience.
Yeah, I mean, I know some people maybe have only just jumped into this track because they own the car and they like the car, but it's quite obvious they don't have enough experience with the car in its current iteration, because who knows, they maybe haven't driven it for over a year.
Yeah, and the baseline setup is definitely, like, quite a bit more difficult than, like, Dan's setups are pretty easy to drive. They tend to be understeery as a whole, which is pretty predictable.
Wow, I'm just watching Arduino's second lap. I think one of his rear axles is broken after contact that spun Aston. Like, it is revving like nuts, but going nowhere. Holy crap. I must be broken left rear drive, man.
Well, that's the one thing that the people at the Skip Bar have been saying is, like, even mild taps to the rear seem to have just killed the drivetrain and give you a meatball.
Yeah, I'm guessing that's must what happened to Arduino's. So sometimes it happens to the P2s, even though the P2s aren't on the new damage model. They'll get a slight tap on the left rear or right rear, and the wheel will just either pop up, or they'll just lose all drive for that thing and can't move.
Sad.
I know we don't want indestructible tanks like things, but there's a nice middle ground to iRacing. Seems to be really far away from it somehow.
Robert's car broke just from that little tap and then going in the sand?
Yeah, that's crazy. Same with Arduino's. His tap was not huge at all, but somehow killed him. Oh, thankfully, I think Thomas gets killed on the in-lap. So that's not actually his last lap of the race, that's his in-lap. Stupid GT1 has decided, it's the in-lap. I'm going to be a prat.
Oh, the in-lap was pretty bad. Like, I always do a cooldown lap and just dodging people left, right, and center.
No, just the 31 decides to be really, really stupid.
I don't know. If you're below 1,000 I rating, you got to be doing something wrong, because I'm horrible. You got to start worrying about crashing like me if you're below 1,000.
Honestly, I've gotten to like 2.5K simply by finishing races and doing not fast times, but okay times.
Yeah, it amazes me. Like, you can get under 2,000. I mean, you can get under 1,000, because don't either you start at 1K or you start at 2K?
You started, I think, either 13 or 1450.
Yeah, when I started, they had it at, I think it was 1350.
So if you get below that, you must be getting killed every single race. And I know it takes more, or even more of the tango, but so there comes a point where you have to think, maybe you are the defining factor.
Yeah, like, honestly, I think when I've been at my worst, I dropped only to like 14 or 15, just from accidents. But then you just have to start finishing races without any problems, and others will wreck, and you'll just gain naturally.
Oh, yeah.
My problem is this is pretty much the only official series I do, and everyone else here is better than me, so my I rating stays at like 1,400.
Same here. This is the only road racing I really race is with these crazy guys, so it don't really go up or down.
And this is my second season of this being my main series, but I don't really consider myself fast, but then I guess I'm not too far off the fast drivers. But I mean, Tyler, you're also not too far off of me when it comes to like qualifying pace.
Yeah, we're not looking for aliens or anything like that. We're just looking for people who can actually wheel the machine for more than a two laps at a time without binning it.
Yeah, and it's that consistency that, like, you will finish higher based by consistency. Is even this race, like, the first two GT1s took each other out in turn one. Like, that's a two free positions from the high, likely the higher I-rating drivers in the race.
Yeah, that was used by then Matthias. Just he was battling with somebody. Kind of he wanted, I guess he was trying to get a jump because obviously the VTC boys are probably communicating the jump. So he's trying to get from fourth to second because the other two get caught napping. But he's obviously just not focused on the corner coming up and just gets preoccupied and kills him. So that happens. You're sometimes over aggressive and it's really easy to miss the braking point and the car just goes straight on because it has no ABS, same as the GT2, but it just happens. But for the rest of the race, they were probably just fine because they know, they have experience with the car, so they didn't kill anybody else.
Yeah, that's what happened to my qualifying, actually. My second lap, I was on pace to be like a half second faster and then had a huge lockup and went off the track and just cooked it.
Yeah, it's really easy to do. You push the car, just make it touched momentarily, and you'll break like half a meter too late, and you will just go straight on.
That's right. I have this bad habit of probably early braking, that I brake like probably 15, 20 meters earlier than I need to, just so that I can brake less and never lock up.
I should brake into the race track. That's a bad habit.
Yeah, I do that too, and then when I look at how slow I am, I'm like, oh, I can go later, and then I lock up, and then we're back to where we started.
Yeah, it's not necessary that you're being later, is that you're getting all your braking done immediately, and then backing off and trailing it into the corner. So you don't have to be late to be late breakers, you just have to be slowing the car down immediately, and then backing off.
So guys, good. Have a nice post-race chat. I gotta go. See you probably next week.
Ciao. Next week. Where's it at next week?
Yeah, I'm just going onto the website. Have a look.
Hockenheim.